Wayne County's pension fund has so little cash at this point that one top official recently said it is in crisis mode.
Yeah, but after more than a year of talk, CEO Robert Ficano is only now taking action to try to right the county ship. 7 Action News investigator Ross Jones is here right now. And Ross, some say Ficano's plan still just isn't, well, it's not enough.
That's what they're saying, Stephen. Carolyn, good evening to you both. This is a story about what Robert Ficano said he would do and what he actually did do. More than 18 months ago, he said he wanted to cut down on a lavish perk that paid him and his appointees $5 for every $1 they put towards their 401k. When the perk became a news story, Ficano said he'd act quickly to end it, changing the 5-to-1 match to a 1-to-1 match.
We're making an announcement that I sent a letter to the retirement board to cut down the package for the 401k.
But then nothing happened. 18 months came and went, and Ficano didn't make any changes. When we asked him why in April, he said it was a tougher task than he thought.
When I looked at it, I thought it would be the only thing that we needed to change. I realized that the county had its most difficulty with the pensions, so we wanted to reform all of it at the same time.
Well, less than a month after our story aired, Ficano finally acted. But he didn't do what he said he'd do. Instead of trimming the perk down to a 1-to-1 match, he changed it to a 4-to-1 match. It affects all new employees or those who've worked for Wayne County for less than 20 years. But if you've worked for more than that, like Ficano, you can still keep the 5-to-1. This plan, he said today, makes the most sense.
We researched the rules and we looked at what was the best practices that were supposed to be accepted in the state of Michigan. The governor's office that published it came out with these particular regulations, and so we're meeting those.
Ficano also reduced how much employees who receive a pension will get going forward. Instead of getting 2.5% of your salary for every year of service, employees will only get 1.5% going forward. Former County Auditor General Brendan Dunleavy said today that Ficano's changes are too little, too late.
The problem's so big, and what you did was so small to fix it. It's not going to make any difference.
He says Ficano's fixes won't put a dent in the problems caused by lavish retirement deals he gave to young appointees like Matt Shank. As we first exposed last month, Shank is only 41, spent 9 years at Wayne County, and is set to collect a $96,000 a year pension for the rest of his life.
Nobody did their job, and that's why you're here today. These are folks that should have been banging their shoe on the table and saying, you can't implement this. It will send the pension plan into bankruptcy or into financial stress. But instead, they were too busy saying, me too.
Now, under that new 4-to-1 match, county appointees can only contribute up to 10% of their annual salary. These changes only affect appointees, not union employees. They need to negotiate any changes done to their retirement plan.
Sometimes it seems like the people at the top don't know what's actually happening out there on the streets when the bad economy like it had. Ross, thank you so much.
Wow. Still to come here on Action News at 6.